The government is planning ways to combat the spread of COVID-19 among its workforce. The Executive Yuan says that if the epidemic worsens, it will start lowering the population density of its workplaces by transferring staff to new offices in Northern Taipei.
At the highest level of government, the presidential office, new protocols are in place as officials brace for an escalation of the epidemic.
At the memorial ceremony, President Tsai honored the late former Finance Minister Sheu Yu-jer with a posthumous presidential citation. It didn't go unnoticed when she bowed to greet ministers instead of shaking hands as part of the new public health precautions. To lower infection risk, the presidential office set protocols urging against physical contact in public spaces. It's created a plan that keeps groups of personnel apart in the event of an outbreak to hamper the spread of the virus.
We're drawing up a contingency plan. It has not been implemented yet, but if the need ever arises, we may divide the presidential office into wings. People from the same unit might be divided up and sent to work at different locations.
The Executive Yuan, which has a large number of staff across multiple ministries, is drafting a contingency plan too. It's leaning toward an emergency plan similar to the one adopted during the 2003 SARS crisis, one that keeps apart the head and the deputy of each ministry.
We're focused on drawing out the distance between the two groups and reducing the density of office populations. We have found some good office locations, all in northern Taiwan. Mainly, we plan to have some people remain at the original office and to move some employees to other offices. Take the Executive Yuan, for example. If Premier Su Tseng-chang is to remain at the main building on Zhongxiao East Road, then Vice Premier Chen Chi-mai will move to a different office.
The Executive Yuan said that in the event of an emergency, its priority would be to keep the virus from striking both a ministry head and a deputy at once.